Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
My friends, and I'm glad that you have joined us for this worldwide transmission. We are going to be here for the next 3 hours. It is February 1st, 2012. And I do want to try to shake things up a bit because what I tend to do is just get into news and issues that get me angry. And that's usually the first or second item I get into. And then not even get to your calls. But we're going to have wide open phones today. In fact, we had some great guests lined up, but I had them canceled because I just want to take your calls and cover the news and go over a wide spectrum of information. I want to explain to you what life's going to be like in 10 years if this new world order continues. You're going to have combat robots basically on every street corner. The entire Air Force will be drone operated like Skynet over the United States. The police will be killing people who don't follow orders. In fact, I forgot to have you guys print court rules. Police can use taser to make you answer questions. You'll get Florida and New York. And police taser man to make him give urine sample. Print me that, too. Because I want to point out, this is pain compliance. This is torture. Because I saw this 2 days ago and didn't cover it. And I'm going to cover it today, where the guy is in a park that for decades has been a off-the-leash park, and the Forest Service just took it over. I actually know of this park in California. I have a buddy and his wife that take their dogs there. I've been there. And it's just, you know, it's in the woods. You're hiking around. There's people with their dogs. It's fun. And they came up and said, we're going to give you a ticket. Stay here. And he goes, I don't have my driver's license and stuff. I just hike here. This has always been an off-the-leash park. And they said, stay here. Starts walking away. They taser him in the back. And it freaked everybody out that watched it. But this is what it's about. They're getting us ready when they're going to kill us. This is a criminal, sicko, control freak government with goons who were there to break our will, grope our children, while their bosses ship in narcotics, kidnap U.S. kids, and fly them out to rape rooms overseas on record. And I don't care if the stupid park rangers and dumb cops out there don't know yet that you work for pure evil, but I'm the one who's here to tell you and explain all this to you. Every movie, every TV show shows checkpoints on highways, men in black uniforms everywhere. Every cop movie I watch now. In fact, I'm going to do a review of this properly next week on the Nightly News when I have time, but I'll talk about it some today. This morning on the treadmill, I'm starting to get up at like 5 a.m. now. I ran basically for 2 hours. No, it was about an hour and 50 minutes this morning on the treadmill, but I watched Law Abiding Citizen. The whole movie is about how great torture is, the Constitution's the problem. At the end, the cop learns his lesson and says, I know now, basically to get rid of the Constitution, by the hero terrorist military black op commander whose family was killed. And the whole thing is this disgusting mind control with checkpoints on highways and black uniforms everywhere. And cops actually watch this, most of them, and fantasize off this false reality. You got a better chance of being killed by champagne corks than by terrorists. But it's all part of this false simulation. The average person in the West that watches TV all day lives in a fantasy land. And that's why when you bring up reality to them, they laugh at you because it doesn't jive with their fantasy land. Bill Gates is coming out with a new technology to kill your sperm. He's proud of it, the eugenicist. We've got huge news on Iran that I will cover. Massive news in the economy. Smart meters going in everywhere, mandatory to control everything and track what's going on in your house. This threatens the crime boss Holder with contempt.
Hi.
Well, there is no doubt that I am overwrought. John Bound, one of our producers and radio directors here, the other day was saying, I feel like I'm in a tank in an info war, cruising along, blasting the enemy. And I said, no, John, you are in the Liberty Command Base, basically a NORAD for freedom worldwide, launching ICBMs at the globalist. Make no mistake, our listeners and fellow liberty lovers worldwide are in tanks and climbing over barbed wire and waking up and freeing minds everywhere. 99% of people are basically in a trance, even if you think you're awake. Every day I realize how much more I learn exponentially. It is wild. Every major movie, the news, the drama shows, the children's TV. I challenge you to watch cartoons now. It's anti-family, anti-male, pro-police state, pro-biometric scan to buy and sell, total brainwashing to screw your children up. Watch cartoons. I challenge you to watch what they're watching while you're in there as a man watching Sports Center. Give me a beer, baby. And she's like, oh, you're so manly. You know, while you're there thinking about how powerful you are and everything, realize that your water's having poison added to it. You're in a scientific dictatorship. And if you want to be a real man, you need to wake up to that fact. And a lot of you are awake, but you're like, well, I'm scared of the system. What is this thing with fear? Why do people love it? I'm afraid of being afraid. You understand? I am such a coward. I want to explain this. This is something I've been trying to articulate to myself. I am such a coward that I'm afraid of being afraid. I am so afraid of giving in and being into fear that I am fearless. I will not be part of this. I will not grovel. Do you understand that? You've got to laugh at this. It is a mind game. It is a mind trick. It is a joke to serve this new world order. It is so clownish that they've got cops all over the country standing around in black outfits and black helmets with machine guns, and police chiefs on record have said it's to scare the public. It's not to make you feel safe. It is a joke when the TSA tries to intimidate you. It is a joke when city council people act arrogant at you like they don't care what you're saying. It is a joke. All of this is meant to break you and train you to be a slave. Not even in an average North Korean town do they have checkpoints and people being groped. Just if anybody reports you for anything, you disappear into a black hole. And it's a culture of groveling and licking the boots of the system. Only here now do people pull up at highway checkpoints randomly set up and are searched. Just thoroughbred, oozing, stinking criminality. Oozing, stinking criminality. With the government sticking their hands down people's pants. All of this. Smart meters, you know, 10 years ago. It's a conspiracy. The San Francisco Chronicle said that these will track your power usage and will control your power. And the engineers from the companies went public, got fired. It all started in California and in London, England. In every case, I've been at events where whistleblowers have actually come. And the integrated circuits, all of it, has algorithm systems that track power usage and even know the signature of a certain brand of blender, washing machine, everything, because it's all been encoded in an industrial program against humanity. I had Stallman, you know, the inventor of free software, on just a few weeks ago, and he was pointing out it's totally set up as a corporate conspiracy. Of course, they laughed at us and said, oh, it doesn't exist. Then about 5 years later, they're like, well, we actually are going to start charging you more when you use too much power with the smart meter, and it is tracking everything you do. And now they're coming out with new appliances that actually have chips that tie into the power with data over it, and now they're going to control the light bulbs in your house, the new fluorescence by law, and actually with burst systems, burst communications, communicate and commandeer your computer's source associated press. Guess where they're already testing it? Police stations across the United States. Started in Minnesota. Now it's moved to many other states and cities. Minneapolis, first city. I mean, it is so incredible that we just let the major corporations under globalist banker control, 6 megabanks, less than 100 megacores under them, bigger than most countries, assassins, spy groups, swallow, prostitute, sex control ops, you name it. I mean, it is just off the charts what they've got now. And it is all just rolling with our money, our energy, all going into a panopticon surveillance grid where everything is automated and controlled by the central technocrats. That's what I've called them for decades. That's what they now call themselves. Because in their own documents, going back to the 70s and 50s and 30s, they call themselves technocrats. 1970 book, Zbigniew Brzezinski. He admits the globalists run organized crime. He admits they run mass murder in Cambodia. You know, he admits in all these books he writes that they've set up a global technocrat system, that they were going to have it built. And he even lists the very time we're living in now, where there'll be the entire Air Force drone, combat robots on the ground, total control. And they've already got all the ground robots. They just know that that's really going to freak people out, and they're not going to roll those out until the next stage terror attack. And then it'll be robots are watching with their infrared, even at night, and they do have weapon systems. They're just now rolling out robots with tasers and things. They use the non-lethal stuff to get you psychologically to begin to see the police attack you with tasers and tear gas. Then they up the power of the taser, up the power of the tear gas, and the billy club strikes, and the arrest for no reason, and police said a month ago, balling up is now assaulting and resisting, so felony charges. If you even raise your arm when they're just cracking your brains out, that's an evil. Just overturning logic, overturning every form of checks and balance and decency and everything good and wholesome. Pure evil. Now, I'm going to get into Assad in Syria, Iran, all of that, what happened in Florida, where that's going. S&P warns a further rate downgrade for the U.S. It's coming. CNBC, housing prices hit post-bubble low. ISSA threatens Holder with contempt. See, they got the dirt on ISSA. That's why they don't even fund somebody to run for Congress unless they slip through like Ron Paul, unless they've got all the car theft records on them like ISSA. You didn't know about that? I learned something every day. Wayne Madsen told me about that yesterday on the nightly news, and I went and looked it up, and it was just constant records and investigations and indictments for car theft all over the United States, military base robberies, everything else. And I mean, this is when the guy was older. I mean, that's who runs this country. I'm sorry. It's just unbelievable. And then he started one of the first big anti-theft alarm companies. That's where he made all his money. Problem, reaction, solution. I mean, tyranny translated is rule by criminals, and not just criminals. You're lucky if you get a tyranny where it's just criminals. You just want power, just want money. It's usually rule by psychos. That's why they build the same structures. The black uniform, the surveillance, the spy, the trudgeon. And their fruits are raping your daughter, poisoning your water, enslaving your society, destroying your job, because they want you in the ditch. They want you in the ditch so poor, uneducated, can't read, can't write, and don't know how to defend yourself, and unarmed, so they can have their way, and they are going to have it good.